Hey guys, it's Final Master Link, and welcome back to Let's Play Castlevania. As you might imagine, I'm actually not playing the game as I'm talking. And I am doing post-commentary because, for some reason, when I was recording with Camtasia, it wasn't picking up my input from my microphone. It picked up the game's audio fine, but not my voice. So I decided just to post-commentate because I really don't want to do it again, so. And I did manage to do it, so, legitimately. So that's why this video was in existence, really. It didn't take as long as I thought, because this video is only about 10 minutes long. Of course, you can skip around if you guys really feel like it. And so in total, I think this Let's Play was about 40 minutes in length. That isn't too bad, I guess. I think Nintendo Capri Suns was about 40 minutes too, so. Yeah, so here's Dracula up here. Basically, what you have to do is you have to hit him in the head. And you have to jump at a certain angle so that you can hit his head, but his fireballs don't hit you. If you aim a little bit too soon, then he's gonna fire them upwards. You have to like wait like a little second before he shoots those fireballs, which I'll show in a second. I'm just getting all my stuff. So yeah, you have to wait like a little second right after he opens up his cape in order to do that. There's other ways of doing it too that I didn't show in the video, like, I heard that you can, whip his head and then whip the, flames real quick as he appears. Yeah, you see, that time I timed it too early, so I got hit with the fireballs then. I think that only happens once. At least what I recorded. And so, the first form actually isn't too difficult. It's really a matter of trying not to fuck up so you can have as much health as you can possibly get. Oh, for some reason my throat's acting up again. Usually isn't like this when I'm in the middle of doing something. And so I'm about to chop his head off. Or wait, don't I die? No, I thought I did for a sec. Okay. So that's the first form, there's the second form, and that's what you have the holy water for. Basically, it's to stun him, and the strategy I would do is I'd throw holy water, and then I would hit him a couple times with my whip, and then repeat. And I got my ass handed to me that time, because the guy cornered me. Because he jumps, he has two different type of jumps. The really high jumps, you can actually walk underneath him, and basically come out unscathed, or it's a low jump and you'll hit him and he'll probably box you in if he doesn't kill you then. So this is me just showing you how to do it again just in case you didn't get it the first time. I'm not sure why, it's fairly self-explanatory. It's just about getting the timing down, and what I like to do is I like to kind of move a little left and right because he can appear so randomly on top of you and then you'll take a cheap hit basically. And unfortunately I can't hear the music or else my mic would actually pick up the music, then it'd be like double music because this is going like in a separate, my voice is going to be in a separate like audio file and the music for the game is going to be in a separate audio file. So in order to not do the same thing twice, I'm basically just watching the screen. Fun, right? Yeah, that time I got my ass handed to me, but it doesn't happen too often. Also, you probably noticed there is a mouse next to player, and that is probably me being a retard. Usually what I do is, you see I use Camtasia's studio recorder, it's a screen recorder. It captures a certain area on my screen. I think there's an option to not show the mouse when I'm recording. I should find that. That'd be pretty useful. Because I know I've done it a couple times before. And it kind of makes you not look good when you do stupid things like that. So really, just ignore the mouse. I think it sits there the whole time, so. And I think what, like, at the start of the video, it wasn't there, but when it came back, I think it's because I, like, hit something and shook the mouse a little because I was getting a little frustrated. Which is fair enough, because this boss is kind of annoying. Not as much as Death, but not nearly as enough as Igor, in my opinion. It's just about getting the timing down and noticing where you are, and then the second round is basically how much health you have. Yeah, those are one of those instances where if he has you a little boxed and you don't think he's going to give you enough room to get a hit on him, then you can just whip the flames, which is what I did a couple times. Yeah, I do it there too. I actually got three of them that time. And so, yeah, even though it's kind of about trial and error the way that this battle works. Like, I think when I finally killed Dracula, I was at full health. In a second form, I was at full health, which rarely happens. But that gave me the edge, and that's how I won. And you'll see in, I don't know, about 3 minutes or so. I don't know, but for some reason, Dracula looks like a fucking huge-ass gargoyle in that form. I don't know why. It just strikes me as strange. I mean, the other form, he looks, you know, like Dracula would, but I don't know. Fucking game. It's a weird one. And also, like, what are those rocks that, like, explode from him? Are those, like, was it his cape? I don't know. I just don't get it. But I'm trying not to get it, because it is a Nintendo game, so. Oh yeah, that time, I actually thought that the flame killed me. So, I didn't record it, but I actually experimented if I could get hit, if I could be killed by my holy water, and I can't. I can just walk on top of the flame. Because because to me it looked like I got killed by the fire, rather than his, like, leg, I guess, just staying still. Yeah, Dracula, second form, he also shoots fire, but not nearly as often, and if you have holy water, you won't be able to do it anyway, so worry more about him stomping your ass than the fireballs, I would say. Yeah, I was so close this time, it really pissed me off. You see how close I was? I was like maybe one or two hits away from killing him that time. And then from then on, I decided to just skip it. And then this time, as you can see, I have full health. And I actually stand a pretty good shot against him. Is this the moment I killed him? See, I got him about halfway. He took a hit on me because of that fucking fire. And it looks like 3/4. Yeah, I spam. I'm glad you have enough hearts. They give you enough hearts for the holy water to use. I am glad of that. I have 2 hearts to spare. And halfway, that's nice. And there I go. I finally beat the game legitimately. With no save states. Now, of course, anyone could, you know, just say, hey, you probably used them, you know, you just didn't show it in the video. Well, in that case, you can go fuck yourself. But, yeah, I did do it legitimately. Whether you want to believe me or not is really up to you. But the point is, I proved it to myself that I could, so that's kind of what counts. Yeah, it sounded kind of gay how I said it, but, yeah. And I think, like, I know I saw the Nerds, review of this game, and I think, like, the cast, they make fun of other names or something like that. Karloffis, like, Boris Karloff, I think he was, like, in one of the original, Dracula movies or something like that. Love Cheney. That's funny. Fishman, Green Stranger, Skeleton, Ander Morrill, Zombie Joan Candles, and the hero Simon Belmondo. Oh, God. That's just weird. You played the greatest role in this story. Well, no shit. We're the only thing that didn't die, I guess. Thank you for playing. And very briefly, I show the, this is the professional mode. It's basically just harder, you know, enemies are, they're harder to kill and you take less hearts of damage. So that's all for this Let's Play. I'll see you guys later.